Dr. Rebekah Diamond's heart broke as she watched another mom sobbing in the intensive care unit. Her 7-year-old son became severely ill with COVID-19 during the Delta wave in the fall. The vaccine had just been authorized for children 5 to 11 years old, but the boy came in contact with the virus before he could make it to his scheduled appointment. "I did everything right for so long and then I decided he just has to go back to school this fall and I sent him back," she told Dime. "I feel like this is my fault, I did this." It was really agonizing to watch her say that, Diamond told USA Today. While the mother may have blamed herself, Diamond blamed regulators for delaying authorization of a safe and effective vaccine for children. The 7-year-old recovered, but the scene of his crying mother haunted Diamond as the Omicron variant ripped through New York City, sending hundreds of children to the hospital each week. As she cared for a new wave of patients, many of them under 5 years old and not eligible to get vaccinated, her frustration with regulators grew. Diamond, who has a 4-year-old daughter, and about 250 other doctors sent a letter to the Food and Drug Administration Thursday morning demanding children under 5 get urgent access to COVID-19 vaccines. The letter argues the science supports immediate vaccine access and procedural red tape is preventing that. "The reason why we're not approving is not from a lack of data," Diamond said. "It's because bureaucratic regulations, likely designed for safety reasons, is now interfering with what's scientifically sound." Parents of young children were hopeful Pfizer-BioNTech's COVID-19 vaccine would be available to their little ones by the beginning of 2022. However, hopes were dashed when Pfizer announced early tests showed the 3-microgram dose given to 2 to 5-year-olds didn't produce as much immune protection as did shots given to other age groups. The company hopes a third dose of vaccine will provide the desired effectiveness, but that means waiting until late March or early April for results. "I was so completely gutted when I saw the news that their trials were extended," said Michelle Tsai, 43, a Brooklyn resident whose 2-year-old daughter. "How much longer will little kids have to wait to be protected by a vaccine that everyone else has access to?" In a statement sent to USA Today, Pfizer said it hopes to have results in the first half of 2022 and, if successful, be able to submit their data to the FDA shortly after. "We're working why. Based on previous actions by the FDA, the COVID vaccine may be available for children 2 to 4 around May," said Drive.